we did an upstander project where students had to, like many of the schools are doing, had to choose an issue that was important in their communities and do something, create some sort of campaign to respond to it. And she looked around in Oakland, and one of the issues that she saw that was impacting probably some of her friends and others around her was underage prostitution. And she, something that, you know, pretty simple to do, her campaign was essentially to create flyers with information about resources that that girls could use when they were experiencing the situation. And she put them up. She went to the places where that she identified as where girls were impacted the most by underage prostitution. If she put these flyers up, and she came into me a few weeks after she had, you know, we'd sort of gone on to the next unit, and she had done this campaign, and she was so excited. And she said, "You're never gonna guess what happened." She said, "I just received an email from one of the organizations who said that this girl had come in with one of her flyers in her hand." So, you know, I don't know, if I would have chosen different sort of curricular avenues and we were just reading books or even watching films, that life change, that transformative experience doesn't necessarily happen and carry with Erica for the rest of her life, both of those experiences, I guess. So just a few examples, anecdotes of how it has become real for my son. You know, I could name dozens of similar experiences, but that's the kind of thing that happens. You know, you sort of, in my first years of teaching, I thought that was like a once-in-a-lifetime thing, right? That kind of connection. And the more I'm doing, the more I'm teaching, but also the more I'm integrating facing history practices and pedagogy into my teaching, the more I realize that it happens many times every year.